Chuck Tully, and I'm standing in front of the Mnuchin Gallery on the Upper East Side, and we're about to go into the exhibition of Cindy Sherman, and the title is Once Upon a Time, 1981 to 2011, and this is one of the greatest post-war American artists, Cindy Sherman. So let's go inside and see what's on the walls.
Hello, Philip Siegel. I'm your dad. Congratulations on your show. Right. How did this come about?
You know, I've been a big fan of Cindy for many, many years, and there were obviously a lot of shows of Cindy's over the years, but always in the gallery environment, or in the White Cube gallery environment, or in the museum environment, and I've always wanted to show her work in a more domestic environment, like in the house. Especially certain series of hers, like the history portraits and the society portraits, which I believe look so good in a house, in a home. So I approached Manuchin and Sukanya to do that show together, and that's how it started.
And this is the first time the gallery has shown photographs?
Yes, sir, yes. Because the main gallery is more post-war America. The gallery is very famous, the best in the world in that field. But they're moving toward contemporary, little by little, but they've never shown photography, that's the first time.
And tell us a little bit, we're standing in front of, in this room of centerfolds, or her title, of great works, and this is the earliest work of the show, in this room. It goes from, I think, 1981 to 2011.
Yeah. The show covers like 30 years of work.
Yes.
And start on the centerfold, which are now an iconic body of work by Cindy.
And not to mention, this particular one that we're standing in front of has, I think, the highest or single photograph by her, whenever, a few years ago, it sold for almost $4 million.
Yes.
Which is a significant...
Yeah, so it's an orange dress, and then it is the icon of the icons, if you can say.
Yes,
so.
Yes.
Because the market is silent, so, you know, it could have been another one.
Yes.
But because, I mean, all these works are so successful, you know, I mean, maybe because of the formats, they are like in box, you know, in this very elongated format. You know, this series was, I mean, originally a commission, and Cindy was given for art form. And because of the format of the magazine, with the fold in the center, the constraints, you know, was the format of the picture, so she had to deal with it. And she's very young, she's very beautiful, as you can see. But also there's a sense of tension, and even of tragedy, you know, like due to the format, you know, and the market decided that was it.
And for those people that aren't familiar with Cindy Sherman, one of her sort of key elements is that she's always the subject,
yes.
Transformed.
Yes.
And as you show, as Mnuchin Gallery is showing in these three different series, we'll go upstairs and see some more of the work.
Yes, she's always the subject, maybe with the exception of two or three images that she did with friends of hers.
Yes.
I think one was Nancy Dwyer, I mean, a few, you know, but in 99.9% of her images, she's the subject. And every image tells a story. And you can imagine the scenario, you can imagine the story. That's why we call this show, Once Upon a Time. Because each one is a beginning of a story that any of us can make or imagine.
The settings
change the colors, and actually even the frames, you know, are done by Cindy. They work well with the image, and they are an integral part of the work. And sometimes they're kitschy, sometimes they're baroque, sometimes they're, you know, and so she plays with it, you know. And that came also into later in the work. I think that started with this story.
You could have a Picasso painting in this frame.
Yeah, absolutely. Or a BBC movie.
Yeah.
Yes.
Phil, now we're going to bring you a history.
Yes. She worked on that series in the late 80s, you know, between, I think, over a couple of years, 1988 to 1990. So we are surrounded by our ancestors, in a way, you know, and in order to, I mean, that's the history portrait also became an iconic series of Cindy. In some cases, she started from existing old master paintings, and she really, tried to mimic them, and other works just come from her own imagination, you know. But with any of them, I mean, we have the conscience to look at a master painting or to look at, again, I mean, a portrait of it can be in a castle, in a French castle, and look at a portrait of an ancestor.
And they're very grand, they're very opulent in a way.
Yeah. Most of them are women, are portraits of women, you know, and some of them they depict men, you know, you're right, they're very baroque, they're very rich, you know, and they make us travel, you know, in time. And again, she played with the frames, you know, when she can tell she had frames sometimes, you know, because I mean, only an artist, you know, would pick a frame like that, you know.
Yes. Yeah.
And the fact that they're framed in a certain way make them make them objects, you know, more than photographs. Mm-hmm. I mean, you don't look at them as photographs. More objects, or more sculptures, I would say.
The thing that's always, in a sense, struck me about her work and just the way she's gone about it and being so successful in so many different ways, art critically, commercially, whatever, from when she was a very young woman, and that she's always maintained her loyalty to her first gallery of Metro Pictures, which is extraordinary.
She maintained a loyalty to her work, and it's pretty amazing to think for many decades she's been working always with the same idea. You know, she hates the word self-portrait, but she's always the subject of the work. And the way she was able to reinvent herself, I mean, series after series, and including recently, a Lachaud picture last year was a revelation for everybody. And so she keeps moving and reinventing herself and improving. And you're right, she's been loyal to her gallery